Hi, hope you guys are doing well. So this is the part 2 of the Blender Beginner series. I'm using Blender 2.83 and we'll be making this sort of scene and animation. So the point of this series is to get you informed in what Blender has to offer. So yeah, but before we get started, few things I need to get out of here. This is part 2. Part 1 was for absolute beginners, but those who have already done something, so this part is for you. Also, I have a Twitter, Facebook page, and an Instagram. So whenever I post a tutorial or share something else, you can follow me there. And it's also a good way to stay connected. Like for example, for some reason, if I can't upload a tutorial, you can actually check this page out for you know, me to inform you if I don't have a video for that week or something like that. Secondly, video parts will be uploaded in different times. Like for example, some days maybe it will be back to back. Like one video and then the next video will be on the next day for the series specifically, and talking about the series specifically, or maybe it will be skipping one day and then the next part will come out, or maybe it will skip 2 days, like next 2 days, but I will try my best that it should be back to back, like one part at least comes out every day. If not, then you know, 1 to 2 day gap will be there. So without further ado, let's get started. My shortcut keys are here. They will be in the EV rendered engine, okay? And yeah, so go to edit, preferences, before we get started, and in the key map settings, turn on, make sure that this is search left, search, drag, and select or toggle, you know, everything, like, make sure that you click this, basically, this is it. And in the add-on section, usually you don't use add-ons, but you know, you need to know what the heck they are. They are basically pre-built functions like modifiers, and they make things a lot easy. So in the search bar, type in images, and check this, I don't know, here, include images as paint, okay? So in the description below, there will be a link to an image, but first of all, A to select everything, and X, delete everything, okay? Now, click to go into side view, and then, because the icon is enabled, now you can see the option is image, and click on reference. So this image is in the link in the description, so be sure to download it, okay? So this is it. I'll just scale it like about 2, okay? So now it's over here, and if you want it to be a little less visible, this menu over here, click on it, click on transparency and change the opacity to 0.5 or you know, anything else if you want to. And remember, this isn't exactly an accurate reference. Our model will look slightly different than this because this is from afar and the angle isn't straight from the side, okay? So remember that. So first of all, shift A, mesh, plane, okay, you can see the plane on here. I think we need to increase our reference, so aspect by 8. Yeah, this looks better. So select our plane and change this to station. The naming is actually important, it really helps to stay organized. If you have a big scene like this, you will be needing it. So this thing was actually pretty big for me to do. So click on the plane. They have to go into edit mode and S, Y, if you don't know which axis is Y, it shows over here, so it's Y for me. S, Y, and then I'm going to click on 15. 15 is almost the same length as this, so it works for me. And then click on 7 to go into top view, and then click on Control R, and you start to seeing this sort of line. Let me show you. Draw this yellow line over here. So when you scroll the mouse, you can actually increase the loop cuts. So add in a bunch of them. I think this one is not for double click, then the loop cuts will be set. Okay, then A to deselect everything. Now click on 3 to go into side view, A to select everything, okay, and G, that to move it to over here, in the same place this place is over here. So deselect everything, and appropriate to this point, I'm going to the edge select mode, click this edge, you know, the one that's proportional to the topmost point of the reference image. Okay, and then click on O when click on O to turn on proportionality. When you click O, this point thing will change to blue color. Okay, so now you know that proportionality is on and the base smooth is should be enabled. Click on G and then click on Z. So you can see that it's only affecting this vertices. Scroll and mouse will increase this this area of influence. You see, this circle is the area of influence. So increase it to move it about the same place as the reference. I think this is appropriate enough. And then click the last part of this edge, then GZ to move it up as well. This part looks a little bit screwed down, so I'm going to flip this as well. I'm going to make the area a little bit smaller. So about over here, and then click on this part over here, and then G to move it about over here. So modeling is basically a lot of tweaking. If you think it's going to be this, well, this part is going to be easy, but you know, it depends on what you're making. So right now I'm going to hide this reference image, okay, and then click on SX to scale it on the X axis. You need to make it a lot thicker on the X axis. Okay, so now we have this ready, this basic group, well, basic group ready. Bring the image back, A to select everything, and then click on EZ to lock it into Z axis, and then move it downward. So now that you have this basic shape, remove the image again, or hide the image again, and then we have this loop. Okay, so click on E, move it down, and then right click to cancel the transformation, and then click on S, turn off proportional editing by pressing O, and then click on S to move it a little bit up inward, and then click on SX to move just it on the X axis. So you know this thing is right. So now that's done. Bring the image back. C to move the side view, and E Z to move it downwards. Now this is like a wave. We don't want it like that. So click on S Z 0 to make it flat on the Z axis. Z and click on wireframe. G and Z to move it like about over here. I think the station looks good. I already informed you guys that this reference isn't exactly accurate, so we're just going to follow it as much as we can, but you know, it's still going to be different. So click on face select mode and select this face. Oh, let's go back to solid mode to use the select. Select this face and then right click to subdivide it. Then going to edge select, click on these edges, and we're going to move them GZ to about here. Click on GZ to move it specifically on that area, okay? And then click on EY to move them about over here. G and move if you want them to be bigger. And then go to face select mode. C to select both of these faces, and then right click to deselect them. And then EZ to move them downwards. Give it a little bit of thickness. Now the problem is that it's created this weird little pitch sort of effect. So go back into edge select mode, select this edge, then shift and select this and this edge, and then this and this edge, and then click on F to fill them. So now it's, you know, filled. Okay, about to go to edit mode, and now we have this basic shape of our station. Okay, so now we're going to be making those prongs. So high TMT, we don't need it. I think the station should be a little bit more bigger. So going to face select mode, deselect everything just to make sure. Then click on C to select all of these bottom faces. And then G, Z to make them slightly more longer. I think about here is okay. So now we're going to create another collection called prong. This is where we're going to be first creating these prongs separately, okay, and then we're going to combine them with the model. So that's the plan. So shift a mesh cube, GZ to move it above, and click on SZ to flatten it out because I don't want it to be tend to look weird and fat. So tap to go into edit mode. Keep on face select face mode. Now there is an easier way to do it, but it's sort of complicated. So I'm going to do another way that's easier for beginners to understand. So try to bear with me. Click on 7 to go into top view. Click on E X because this is the X axis. You see, this is the X axis. So these things are need to be kept in mind when you are extruding or moving, etc. So E X M 3. I think 3 isn't appropriate. So E X 4 4x squared. So this was positive x axis. So this side is negative x axis. So if I'm going to move it, if I want this part to extrude over here, so I'm going to go into EX minus 4 so it can move over here. Now, the same way, we're going to go it at the y axis, select this face, hold it up to EY4, they are linked to be equal. And again, this back part EY-4. There is an easier way to do this, but it actually requires changing a lot of these settings, and they're just confusing for now for beginners. So it's better to escape it this way. Now deselect everything. Now as you can see that there's these slight tiny boxes are being made. These are going to be what we're going to be using next. So to measure what we're going to be doing. So as you can see, there are tiny boxes over here as well. So I'm going to click on Control R, okay, and click to finalize the loopout, and then going to move it about over here where the box ends. Similarly, Control R, click to finalize it, and then move it over here to place it. Control R again and move it over here. Since this is going to be observed from afar, it is like a minor detail. It doesn't need to be very neat and tidy. Okay, it works well. Now hide the station. Go to face select mode. Select the bottom faces, and then make the station reappear again. EZ to move them downward and about over here. This is good enough because we're going to be creating the base later on, so they're just going to hide and going to be hidden anyway. And this is low poly style anyway, so it doesn't matter much. And since this model looks, station looks pretty small, click on SY to make it a lot longer. So now it looks a lot more lengthier. Then click on this one prong, and going to this object properties section, and on the z-axis change this to 45. So now it's rotated like this, like you wanted it to, and click on shift D G Y and move it about over here, and then click on shift D G Y and move this as well. So now we have this separation sort of one. The original had like 5 of them, but I think this one works better. And but if you want to change it up a bit, I think I can with S shift Z, so they look like they actually don't work well. I think this looks pretty okay. So now we're going to create the rest of them, the rest of the spawns. They're going to be fairly simple, but we're going to be needing another cube, and S shift Z to make it slimmer because these are already hiding between them, but the cube isn't. And yeah, so G and X to move it on the side, like about here, the same as them, and then GY to move it about here, and then SZ to scale it about this length, 1 to go to side row, and then shift DGX to move it on this side. Now, before we go into further, we're going to just create the basic material, not the complete material, just the basic material. So, click over here, select the base material, and I'm just going to call this material as PRONG prong. And it just change the base color for now to pure white. We're going to be just giving them base colors, and then we're going to be editing this material to look more finer and better later on. Do the same with this one, with the prong material. All of them also need to be found here. Okay, now select this prong, and then shift click and select this prong. Okay, to go to side view, and then shift D, G, Y to move both of them over here, and then S, Z to scale them down. G, Z, and about over here. Okay. So make sure that they look appropriate from the top view. The bottom it's okay because we're going to be adding a base later, so it's going to disappear anyway. As said, to move it a little bit more. Okay. Shift E G Y again and move this time to about over here, and S Z to move about here. And then shift D G Y to move this to the side as well. Then shift D G Y to move it to the side. About here, and as that to scale them downwards. I think this looks appropriate enough. They already have the base prong material, and now we're going to give the station material. So click on new to create a new material. Name it roof. And for now, right, like I said, we're going to be editing this material later on. But for now, just give it a red color. Then click on a new material. plus button to add this part, and then click on new to add another material and name this one window for now. And I guess we'll give it a light blue color just to signify the color, but we're going to be editing these materials later on. So now with the selection selected, Z, material preview. So by default it's given the roof material to all everything, but we want the roof to be just the red color to be just on the top and the window material to be on the bottom. And remember, these materials are just this, so that we are going to be making proper materials later on. So tab, going to edit mode, and you select everything, Z, wireframe, side view, and B to box select. Select everything, because we're in edit mode, it's going to only affecting I don't know why it's doing this. And click on assign. While selecting the window material, click on assign. They have to go to effect mode and then go into material preview. And right now it has the window material. We're going to be editing these materials later on. I think this part hasn't been affected properly. So I'll just edit it later off. But if you want to click on see. Then click on assign, do not change it back. So this looks appropriate now. So in the next part, we'll be creating the base of the station and maybe this road part. So please subscribe to our channel, leave a like, tell a friend, don't waste this time during quarantine, learn a new skill. So see you next time. Goodbye.